Alright guys, today I'll be doing the Aluminess ladder and surf pole. And I just want to make a disclaimer. This is not the way Aluminess wants me to do it, because this is for the Unistrut rail that I installed on the van. I called Aluminess and asked, because on the YouTube videos, these are not pre-drilled, but they're pre-drilling them now. This is for the ladder, this is for the surf pole. So the hardware they gave me, like I said, was for the standard factory Mercedes rails. I do not have those, I have Unistruts, which in my opinion is a lot stronger, but yeah, not gonna go there, but I think it's better. If I were to do it again, I'd do the same thing. Not to mention, it's like $700 versus $60. Okay, getting a good look before I install the surf pole and ladder. I got these at Home Depot. These are great because since I got all these in, they sell them where you could slide them through, but these guys you can just push in and twist, and you could put it anywhere you want. All right, so I got it hanging right there. That looks pretty good. Well, I got my little buddy here helping me out, but I got these clamped up, and really, that's really not a lot of room to mess up. Did you just turn that on? Did you just turn that on by yourself? Huh? Are you recording me? Dude, you're not even two yet. You know how to use that thing? Okay, stay back, buddy. Did you need eye protection for this? Okay, don't go near here because I'm gonna be drilling. Yes, Daddy?
Yes, Daddy.
Okay. That's two, huh? Hold on, bud. Chee-hoo! Okay, I just got some of that paint I used for the Max Air Fan Dome.
No.
Yes. So we're gonna touch it up. Get some paint going on in here. Don't touch. You just watch from here, okay? Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Daddy.
Yes, sir. Yeah, Kaka's in this crate. Come on, there you go, that's two. Huh? Yeah. Okay, so here's what we're looking at. Just came back from the store. I got these 3/8 by 1 inch bolts, split washer, washer. And we're coming right into that little fitting. Like I said, I'll torque these down right. It's just I'm just trying to beat the sun.
A few moments later.
So on the surf pole, it's pretty much the same thing, but smaller. We're gonna let that. All right guys, big day, big day. After months and months and months and months of waiting, the windows are coming today. So I'm gonna work on it for the next day or two. And on the third day, my buddies will come and help me mount it on, cause it's a pretty big window. I wanna make sure I get it eyeballed all right. Okay, I got it all boarded up on the inside, cause last thing I want is metal shavings on the inside there. So next thing to do is to start drilling holes. Like I said, super stoked that pretty much is the template. And once I got it drilled out, I'll just cut along the sides. Just like what we did here for the flare space. I mean, it gets so serious where you start doubting if I'm doing the right window. I did, yes. I guess it doesn't get old putting holes in your car. Just like how it is. No turning back now. Oh, I can't wait till this thing, is put in. Which I'm still waiting for it in the mail, so he said it's coming today. I sure hope it is. So I sure am glad I went to elementary school, because I never thought connecting the dots would apply, and sure enough, it does. So some people get mad, some painter's tape and go around to protect the paint, but we're gonna glue right over it, so I'm not gonna do that. Okay, years ago I was working, and I just got out of the car and something flew in my eye. Like, I don't know what it was. So I went to the doctor and I said, something's in my eye. The doctor goes, okay, he gets this Q-tip. He goes on the outside of my eye, grabs my eyelid and curls it all the way back. I'm like, okay. Then he gets this other Q-tip and he shoves it as far back in my, I could have swore it touched my brain. Enough, I was just like, to my mouth, was like, ah. And then he takes it out. I don't want that to happen again. So we're gonna be extra safe here. Let's go. All right, I am super glad I got this thing. Look at all these metal shavings everywhere. I'm getting it all over my shirt. It's falling in my shirt. More PPE, the better. Kind of got sketchy a little bit when it fell on the corner. I got metal shavings just all on me and under my shirt. Wow. Okay, you know what time it is.
What's up?
Say what's up to the GoPro. I cut a hole, look at that. I cut a hole, big one.
Oh my lord, what are you doing?
Dude, look at this. Look at this. I just cut the window out, and look what just got here. Oh, okay. If that's not density, I mean, destiny, Lorraine. I don't know what is. Your timing's perfect, buddy.
I got a pallet for you.
Yeah, they sent you to help me install the window, right? No. Alright. I just cut it out. Your timing's perfect.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's a big van.
Yeah, it's kind of big. Yeah. Actually, my dream would be to drive from here to New York and then up to Toronto and all the way to Vancouver, down to Seattle and back home.
Ooh.
That's my dream. I don't know if it'll happen, but
that's a lot of driving.
It's a lot of driving, but they say you only live once. And if you do it right, one's all you need.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, it's gotta
anyway, try. Anyway, we're gonna have to try to live every day as the very last day.
That's true.
That's what you should do. We should enjoy whenever we can, because once you get older, I mean, I'm 61 years old, and I wish I enjoy. I really did the thing that I wanted to do now, right, when I was 25. Whatever you get, my advice, I'm 61 years old, try to do it now.
I'm doing it. But I'm 41, so I'm a little late to the game.
Oh my God, really?
Yeah.
You don't look 41.
Oh, stop.
No.
Come on.
I tell you what about 32.
Oh, 33? Stop it. Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I swear.
All right.
You don't look 41.
I'll take it. I still got hair. Not as good as my dad's, but I still got hair.
Still, you can do it now.
Okay. Let me grab a mask, I'll help you with that.
That's okay.
You sure? You said you're 61, I can help you.
Let me see.
Okay.
Actually, you are my last delivery.
I'm the last one, okay.
You are the last one.
Save the best for last.
Yeah. And we have a beautiful day today, so you have plenty of daylight.
I'm with you.
Where?
Let me get you a cold drink, it's hot.
Oh, good, thank you.
Yeah.
Where do you want it?
We'll just slide it right here.
Slide it?
Yeah.
You might want to lift it probably. Is it fragile? Is it glass?
It's gotta be. See what it says here?
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome. What's your name?
Leo.
Leo. Okay, Leo.
All right. Have a good one, and I hope you well done the project here.
I'm gonna put it on YouTube.
You gonna put it on YouTube?
If I ever get brave enough to do that stuff, but yeah.
When are What's going to be the name of YouTube when you finish?
You know the, have you heard of the Avengers, the movie, the Avengers?
Yeah.
This is the Avengers.
Avengers.
All right, Leo, thank you.
All right.
See ya.
He said I look younger than 41. What a compliment.
Shout out to Leo from GSO, man. That guy's a gem. Best of luck to him. And I told you, Leo, it's going to be the Avengers. And if you're seeing this, buddy, which I hope you are, thank you.
Yeah, about that earplug thing. Highly recommend it. I should be wearing it, but I put it down, and that is my problem. Every day, I put something down, I don't know where I put it. I keep telling myself, just put it back in the right places, but I don't know why I don't. Story of my life. Okay. One window cut out. Let's go for the other one. And I could take a shower because I got metal shavings everywhere. And I could swear I'm due for like a tetanus shot, so I don't even want to go there. The beautiful thing about this is I'm learning as I go. So, I was kind of sketchy cutting this out because I cut the top first. It started peeling and I'm like, oh my gosh, is this thing going to peel more than I need it to? Luckily it didn't. That was luck. Today I got lucky. So now on the second window, I'm gonna cut the top last. I never done this before. We'll keep it in 1,000, you know that. So.
Round two, let's go.
Before I start, I just wanted to talk about today. Just wanted to talk about today's sponsor for the video. It's me, damn it. Get out of your comfort zone. Go for it. I'm out of my comfort zone for sure. Okay. What I realized on the first one is I drilled too many holes, which, no, I'll tell you what I mean by that. My jigsaw keeps getting hung up on here. See that? Cut from the inside. Let me give that a try. Let's see how it goes first. I don't know if it's gonna work cutting it from the inside, but it's worth a shot. This is the last window we're cutting in, but it's worth it's good information for you guys, right? It's all preference, but I don't even know if I could cut it from the inside, but we'll soon see. Oh my gosh. Note to self. Actually, note to you guys too. Oh wait, go ahead, grab a pad and paper. Okay, so, dude, it is clean. Cut from the inside. When this thing's cut out, I'm gonna do a comparison, but cut from the inside, it's super clean.
I'm almost done. But I really can't wait to show you guys how much cleaner it is cutting from the inside. It only took to the last window to realize that, but hey, it's for you guys. You're welcome. Which reminds me, go ahead and just hold that phone back vertical and you can see the little thumbs up. You don't have to smash it, just give it a love tap. Go ahead and wait. Got it? Okay. Well, I bent two blades on that one. I jinxed myself, but that's not bad. No blades on the first window, two blades on the second. But let me show you. Let me show you how clean that is. I mean, I think it's cleaner. I think it's cleaner. To me, it was a lot easier to follow though. Because I'm not really hitting that inside wall as much. Like right here, see, it's all outside wall I'm hitting. All right, go. Have fun, little one.
Bye.
See ya. Day two. We're just gonna file and paint. See you guys. Love you. Wish I could join them, but we got work to do. And in order for us to go out and explore, I gotta stay and do this. As you can tell, sun's getting low, big guy.
Is that enough space?
Yeah, you know what Wheezy said, right? I'm a Martian, I need my space.
all the way to the corner.
Okay.
Okay, that's flush right there. Any more flush, I'll need a toilet.
Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna explain what we're gonna do.
We're just gonna glue these two together and just see how the bead spreads, so we have an idea how far. It says half an inch, but you never know. That depends on how much stuff you use, right? So
this is the primer that we gotta wait 10 minutes to dry. So basically just primered it up. I put a piece of tape here in case glue does ooze over, we could take it off easy. Here we go, doing a practice bead. Just see how it spreads. I got you. Dang, that thing is thick. It's pretty thick, dude.
Yeah, it's thick.
It ain't going nowhere.
Yeah, it's not gonna spread too much.
No.
When we squeezed it, that's the thickness of the bead.
Mm-hmm.
So we're gonna put it right on the line. It should line up like that.
Okay.
And it will be clean. It's not going to seep out.
Yeah.
And this thicker part, we're going to add. Oops.
No, go for it. What are we going to add?
No, we're just going to add more bead to the bottom. Increase the surface area.
Check. Do you want to tell them your name? Would you when you're using this gun?
Cock that.
I'm not as cocky as you, but I'll try my best. Okay, so we got it beaded up. I went double here on the outside. Say goodnight. Good night.
Thank you guys so much.
See ya. Thank you, my brothers. Just wanted to say I got these online at Amazon. They did not work good at all. So don't recommend you guys getting that. I would get the single one. Just the single one. Well, that's a wrap for the windows, guys. Fan's actually starting to look really cool. Special thanks to my buddy Jay and his brother Melvin for helping me get these guys installed. Yeah, that's it for this video. Like I said, give it a nice little love tap. You don't have to smash it. And talk to you guys later. Oh, you thought that episode was over? Well, I did too. Apparently it rained. Well, it did rain. And this window leaked, which is not good for me, but great for you. And there's not a lot of videos out there that show troubleshooting for the windows. And I called Van Windows Direct, and he told me I should go on the inside and caulk it. I did see a guy put some tape here, and then he put some more of that silicone bead and shoved it through with a screwdriver, which seems like a great idea. But the guy at Van Windows Direct said to go buy some caulking, black caulking or clear, and caulk the inside because the leak's very minimal. It's just, it drops in one section. So we're gonna do that and hopefully it works. Right here, the caulking. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go all the way across and hopefully that fixes it. Yeah, but I do want to say, I talked to the guys at Van Windows Direct and their customer service is super, super dope. He told me what I should do. I told him about coming in from the outside. He highly recommends to do the inside. And I said, if that doesn't work, what do I do? And, he said that I'd have to take the window off and there's a special tool. I don't know, some kind of grinder or whatever, that they said they would actually mail to me so I could borrow it to do it and I could mail it back. That's amazing. And I also heard they're talking about doing some awning windows this size, which I missed a train on it. But I mean, I'm still pumped about this slider, but awning windows, yo, that's dope. Like the Arctic turn. But he also said they got, after that, they're going to be working on rear awning windows. My original plan is to keep it just like that. Because I feel we don't need windows in the back. But awning windows! Well, you see that? That's rain. Yes, and we took the Mark 1 for a spin yesterday. Dun dun dun! No more water leak! Not a terrible job at the caulking, but it is done. Jarvis, you ready? And you see that there? That's our next project. We're off to Lowe's to go get some material. Actually, all I need is 3 10-foot sticks of Unistrut, but we're gonna leave you guys here on this episode, and next time you see us, we'll be probably do an episode in itself. For actually want to get detailed on this one for the roof rack install for the deck, I mean. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take care of that right now. Thank you guys for watching, and you know all that good stuff. Click subscribe, all that. Hopefully you guys can. Keeps me going, because you know it is full-time parents, full-time jobs. It is hard to do all this
the build alone, let alone documenting it and editing and all that. But yeah, give it a like, subscribe, all that good stuff. See you guys next.